It seems like my mother is bragging about me to every single person she knows. It makes me happy and all, but honestly, if there was a hole, I'd want to crawl into it.
I finished the new designs. You want to take a look?
Who in their right mind would want to wear clothes like this?
I'd wear them any day.
Why can't you come up with casual designs that people will actually wear? You gotta stop acting like you're royalty. If I lived in your kingdom, I'd rather be naked.
It's not my fault. Christmas is coming, so my head's filled with festive images.
What do you mean? Your head's filled with flashy images all year round.
I have a shoot this afternoon, so I should get going.
Wow, you work all the time now, Caroline.
Oh, I almost forgot. I have a shoot, too.
Huh? It's so infuriating. Everything comes so easily to him. I've gone through so much just to have a shot at modeling. He decides to do it on a whim, and all this work falls in his lap.
You sound like you're bragging about him more than anything else.
That's not what I'm doing.
Go on and brag. It's more honest that way. Repeat after me. My boyfriend is so cool, he can do anything.
But you know what? He still wouldn't be as great as Tokomori.
Whoa! What do we have here? He is hot. Yukari, is this guy really your boyfriend?
Yep.
I'm sorry, but I can't talk to you anymore. I hate you too much. Huh? Poor Tokomori, you must be heartbroken. Do you need a bosom to cry on?
What are you talking about? Stop being ridiculous. There's no way Tokomori would fall for someone like me.
She really believes that, huh?
Huh?
Merry Christmas!
Whoa, this looks awesome. You've outdone yourself, Isabella. Great! I'll stuff myself till I can't walk.
It's not healthy to stuff yourself silly.
Then I'm drinking myself silly.
You know that you probably shouldn't, right, Arashi? Wow, it's snowing.
It's pretty late. Is your mom gonna be mad?
Well, I told her that I was going to a party with some friends and that I might not be getting home until really late tonight. My mom and I've been getting along pretty well. I think it might be because she's rather proud of me lately.
Really?
Truth be told, it's embarrassing.
You think so? It's quite different for me. I feel great when someone I love gets complimented by others.
George, someone's at the door.
Uh-huh.
Hey, George.
Who could it be? It's the middle of the night.
George, stop.
George!
Who are you?
Sorry, I beg your pardon, do you have any idea how late it is?
Hey, calm down.
I don't want you to get the wrong idea. It's not what you think.
Then why'd you ring the doorbell so incessantly? You could have broke the thing. Who the hell is this girl anyway?
This is between her and me.
George!
Sorry about that, Kaori.
It's okay.
Kaori?
Will you explain things? Tell her it's not what she thinks.
Don't worry about it. Come on in.
That's okay. Maybe some other time.
I have an idea. Why don't you stay the night like you used to? You know, for old time's sake.
George! Look, I've never spent the night here, okay? Not even once, I swear. You know, sometimes I just don't get you. You can't just give up on your dreams of becoming a professional designer. It would be a waste of your talents.
I take it you read my email, then.
Have you given Mr. Kisaragi an answer yet?
He's in Milan on business right now.
I see. Well, it's a good thing I rushed over here. There's no way I'm letting you go through with this!
Aren't we the little busybody?
Come on, Yukari. Help me out here, will ya? Talk some sense into this guy. You've seen his talent. You love it as much as I do, right? If he stops designing, he'll just be like every other arrogant, stupid jerk.
I have no intention to stop designing clothes. As it is, I've been selling pieces to people I've met through my modeling work. And I've gotten special requests for outfits for photo shoots.
Oh, so does that mean you've changed your mind?
No, I'll design whenever I can, but I don't plan on doing it full time.
Are you serious? Why didn't you tell me?
I was planning on telling everyone at the studio, but today was our Christmas party and I didn't want to spoil the mood, so I put it off.
George,
they're going to be disappointed. You'll be dissolving Paracus, right?
But why?
I'm planning on apprenticing with Seiji after I graduate.
Oh yeah? Over my dead body you are!
He's promised me an amazing starting salary, and he's even said eventually he'll help me go independent.
George.
If you accept his offer, you'll wind up a hair and makeup artist for the rest of your life.
No matter how I look at it, I just can't reconcile the business end of being a designer. I only know how to make the clothes I want to make.
And what's wrong with that?
Nothing, if it were just about me. But I have to think of my mom. She's weak and entirely unable to support herself on her own. So I can't have an unstable lifestyle, for her sake. If my old man should die in an accident or something, then my mother and I would suddenly become homeless. I'm sorry you came all the way out here, but I've agonized over this and I'm not changing my mind.
I understand where you're coming from, but still...
I don't understand. I mean, George is always relaxed and carefree in front of me. Why? Why didn't he come talk to me about any of this stuff?
I'll be back. It looks like there's no talking to you right now anyway. And no matter what you say, I can tell I'm still intruding.
I think it would be best if you also went home right now as well. I thought I was perfectly clear. Kaori is a precious friend of mine. Couldn't you have at least tried to behave more politely? I could care less if you don't trust me. I'm saying this now in defense of Kaori's honor. I have never, ever slept with her. Kaori's just not that sort of woman.
Gotta pee.
What are you doing? Don't go reading my text messages!
It's your own fault for sneaking around behind my back.
Give it back!
If you don't want people reading your messages, then maybe you should have deleted them!
I told you before. There's nothing going on between Hiro and me.
I know that. That's not the issue. He's just so goddamn perfect. He'd never do anything immature like force himself on you like I did. Am I right?
Miss Hamada, so you come to school during winter break, eh? If I'd known you were that lonely, I would have taken you out on a date.
I came into work because I'm busy! Here, I picked up what I could find. You may want to check them to make sure they're all there.
You didn't have to do that. Even if they did get made, it's not like anyone would wear them.
If it's trash, then put it in a trash can!
Yes, ma'am.
Koizumi would be ruined if he decided to turn pro. He makes clothes to escape reality by creating a fantasy to live in. It's how he gets his fix. But with the harsh reality of the fashion world, he'd end up with a bad trip. His world would be shattered, and possibly his sanity, too.
George Koizumi! Being a ready-to-wear clothing designer isn't the only kind of designer there is! You're young! You're only 18! How can you be so pessimistic about life already?
I checked the stack, and all of my sketches are there. Thanks, Miss Hamada. I really appreciate it.
Koe o arete Kimi ni kuchizuke o Paradise kiss o Koe ni naranai da yo Kimi ga hidoku junsui de Koe ni naranai da yo Minna yasashisugiru yo Koe ni naranai da yo Boku wa hidoku ayauku de Koe ni naranai no wa Muzaki na kimi no Sei sa
What a wonderful song!
How long have you been there? That's just great. Miwako. Is that your new cell phone? How much was it?
Huh?
I don't have that much money right now, but I'll give you the rest soon.
It's okay. I shouldn't have been texting behind your back anyway.
I know in my head that how I reacted was wrong. Sometimes I just get so crazy I don't know what to say or do. And I'm really sorry.
Hey, Miwako! We made a sale!
Huh?
Arashi, one of the outfits on consignment sold. I just got off the phone with the sales lady from the boutique it was at.
We made a sale! Isabella, our first sale!
Oh, good. You're finally here. You took your time as always, I see.
You're the one who called me out of the blue. I have commitments of my own, you know.
Shall I go ahead and begin serving dinner now?
Please. And get me another hot sake.
Yes, sir.
Your girlfriend visited me at the office yesterday.
Yukari? What'd she want?
No. I'm pretty sure she said her name was Kaori.
Oh yes, Kaori the busybody.
Well, if I knew she wasn't your girlfriend, I would have made a pass at her.
So, what'd she want?
She told me that she wanted me to give you your freedom. She said that if I guaranteed your mother's financial future, you'd be able to pursue your dreams and that you were sure to become a success. And she requested all this on her hands and knees. You know, George, your friends really do care about you. So, is this Yukari girl pretty?
You could say that. Make sure you give me a call first the next time you come to Japan. I can come pick you up.
You would do that? Well, then you must really love me.
Sure, I love you.
I gotta say, you should stop talking like that. You have a girlfriend. No wonder your relationships don't last. You have a boyfriend, too. You're going straight to hell if you keep this up. You know that, right?
Yeah, but I won't mind. I'll weave dresses out of mats of thorns. I know a great spot to see the sunrise. Do you want to go after our New Year's trip to the shrine?
Okay.
Happy New Year!
Here's to you putting up with my stupid son for another year.
Happy and what?
You're late. The New Year's already begun.
Mm-hmm. Hey there, Miwako. Happy New Year to you, too.
So which shrine should we go to? Since we're doing it, might as well go somewhere big.
Are we all going together?
I wanted to go alone with you, just the two of us. Arashi wanted to go together, though. Huh?
Ah! Arashi! Congratulations! You've grown up a little bit, Arashi! Let's grow some more this year, too!
What the hell does that mean?
It
says more!
Us, too! Arashi!
It's so beautiful.
Yeah, but still not as beautiful as you.
Thank you.
Yukari, I've decided to move to Paris after I graduate. I plan to work at a haute couture fashion house.
What? Wait, but I thought you said you were going into the makeup industry.
I talked to my old man, and he actually wants me to follow my dreams.
I see. But it's easier said than done. You can't expect to join a fashion house just by moving to Paris.
As long as I try hard, it'll work out.
Isn't that a little unrealistic?
You think? You'll never get anywhere thinking that way. You have to believe in yourself. It'll work out. Are you sad because we have to say goodbye? I'm going to be very lonely in Paris without you. You could always come with me.
I won't. And besides, my modeling career has just taken off. And I still want to go to college. So that's why.
I wouldn't have it any other way.
I didn't end up getting into college. Tokomori got into his top choice for medical school, though. He's currently working on becoming a psychologist.
Bonjour, mademoiselle.
Caroline, ça va?
Comment allez-vous?
Huh? Really? You finally graduated too?
Oui. Now we can celebrate all of our graduations.
And throw a farewell party for George at the same time. Come, everyone, help me with the cooking.
Okay.
You know, Carrie, if you're no longer going to attend college anymore, you could technically go to Paris with George.
Caroline.
That could be asking too much of you. You have your own life to live after all.
Right now, my focus is just on my next modeling job. Good luck with your work, too. You're gonna make patterns for a big name brand, right? I think that's great.
She even wore a man's suit to the interview. She looks super cool in it, too.
I wish I were there to see it. In the end, Paracus only sold one piece of clothing, the one on consignment. The label was dissolved when everyone graduated.
What I really want is to be able to make a living by playing in the band, but that's tough to do. I can always keep playing for the babies while slaving away at some studio.
I'm gonna be the newest employee at Happy Berry.
Can you say nepotism?
What's wrong with having connections?
You've been familiar with Mikako's designs ever since you were little. No one understands Happy Berry better than you. I'm sure you'll be a great help to her.
Really? Me? I can help my big sis?
I have no doubt that you'll end up becoming Mikako's right-hand woman.
Yeah, and I better work hard like everyone else. Besides, I have a shoot for a TV spot tomorrow.
Wow. That's awesome! A toast to everyone's future!
Cheers!
Good luck on that photo shoot tomorrow.
I'm sorry. I won't be able to see you off.
You took the job on purpose, huh? Take care.
Thanks. You too. A stiff leather passenger seat. His suffocating cologne. The heat from his body. And the cold touch of his fingers. His intense gaze. Or the sound of his low voice, sweetly calling out my name. I don't care which one it is. Just leave me something to hold on to, George.
I'll be fine. I have a credit card.
I still think it's safer if you have some local currency. Here.
Thanks, Mom.
Cut!
I believe that he really left us.
Yeah.
You really don't mind if I wear these?
No.
But didn't you say they had special meaning to you?
Yeah, they do. And that's why I want you to wear them. What are you doing aboard this ship?
Abandoning everything to live for love is one form of happiness for a woman.
One can't live on love alone, so what'll you do from now on?
What else is there to do? I'm going to make the patterns for your dresses.
In a month, I'll be getting married.
Hey, sis, your fiancé's here. Wait a minute, are you sure you want to wear that? Your ex-boyfriend made it.
Oh, be quiet, will you? It's fine. Besides, it's what I look best in.
All right, then.
For our honeymoon, we plan on taking a trip to America. There's a popular musical on Broadway right now that we want to see, and we have special invitations to it. The costume designs are by George Koizumi. It's supposed to be a comedy, but I know that when I see it, I'm sure I'll cry.